Good morning to everyone. In this lecture, EC8551 Communication Networks, third year ECE, Unit 1, Fundamentals and Linked Layers. In this lecture, we are discuss about the topic Data Link Layers. First of all, the introduction of Data Link Layers. This layer takes the data frame or message from the network layer and they provide their actual transmission. At the receiving computer, this layer receives the incoming data and send it to the network layer for handling. The link layer also provide error-free delivery of data between the two computers by using the physical layer. It does this by packing the data from the network layer into the frame, which include error detection information. At the receiving computer, the data link layer read the incoming frame and generate its own error data information based on the received frame data. After receiving the entire frame, it then compares the error detection values with the incoming frames, and if they match, the frame has been received correctly. We see the data link is represented for transmitting frame from one node to next node, that is hop to hop delivery. We see the block diagram. The physical layer is used to the network layer. The data will transferred to incoming frame to another frame. Now, the functions of data link layer. First one is a framing. Framing is a divides the data from network layer into frames. Second one, physical addressing. Add a header to the frame to define physical address of the source and the destination machines. Number three, flow control. It is a traffic regulatory mechanism implemented by data link layer that provide the fast sender from drawing the lower receiver. Number four, error control. It provide the mechanism of error control in which it detect retransmit damages or lost the frames. Number five, feedback. After transmitting the frame, the system wait for the feedback system. Now, the next slide, network layer. The network layer, this is the responsible for addressing messages and data so they are sent to the correct destination, and for translating local addresses and names into physical addresses. This layer is also responsible for finding a path through the network to destination computer. So we see the network layer. The network layer is responsible for source to destination delivery possible across multiple networks, whereas the data link layer over the delivery of the packet between the two systems on the same network. The network layer is responsible for delivery of individual packets from the source host to destination host. So, the functions of network layer. Number one is interface between the host and network, that is the network layer is typically the boundary between the host and subnet. Second one is routing. Third one is congestion and deadlock. And the fourth one is internet working, that is a path many transfers different network technologies. For example, Ethernet, point-to-point links, etc. So here, source to destination delivery in the physical layer path, the intermediate system is linked to intermediate topologies to the source system to end system. So the end system is an intermediate system to host delivery to step by step in the network data link in the physical layer methodology. Now, the second layer is transport layer. The data is delivered error-free in sequence and with no losses, duplications or corruptions. This layer also repackages data by assembling long messages into lot smaller messages for sending and repacking the smaller messages into the original longer messages at the receiving end. The transport layer is responsible for delivery of a message from one process to another process. We see the block diagram. We see the two systems, the network layer host-to-host delivery, the transportation layer to process the responsible for delivery of one message from one process to another process. Next one, session layer. It allows two applications to establish, use and disconnect a connection between them called a session. It provides for name recognition and additional functions like security, which are needed to allow applications to communicate over the network. We see that the session layer is responsible for dialogue control and synchronization. Next one is a presentation layer. We see the diagram. The format used to exchange data among network computer, the presentation layer is responsible for translation, compression and encryption. Number one, encoding data in a standard agreed upon way. Number two, it manages the abstract data structure and convert from representation used inside the computer to network standard representation and back. And then application layer. Application layer is it provides applications with access to network service. The application layer is responsible for providing services to the user. We see the human or program user in the two layer. That is using the presentation layer, the data is forwarded to the industrial or specific applications with access to the network service. This is a link layer addressing. We see the link layer addressing. The layer in the protocol exactly match the open system interconnection model. The original transmission control protocol suited for defined having a four layers. That is, one is host to network, second one internet, third one transport and applications. However, when transmission control protocol is compared to open system interconnection protocol, we can say that the protocol suited five layers. That is a physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, finally application layer. We see the transmission control protocol respect to function of the different OAS model. The next slide, for the example of how the physical address and IP address help in data communication. We see the block diagram. A part of an internet with two routers connected their LAN, that is a local area network. Each device, that is a computer or router, has a pair of addresses, that is a logic or physical. For each connections, in this case, each computer is connected to only one link and therefore has only one pair of addresses. Each router, however, is connected to three networks. That is only two or more networks. So each router has three pair of addresses, one for each connections. The physical addresses will change from hop to hop, but the logical addresses usually remain the same. Thank you for watching this video.